viewers. My name is Nasif Shelagbery, your host for Big Issue program today. Beside me, I'm having one of the public analysts in Ilorin, Mr. Aliu Adam. He is the guest for today's program. He will be discussing with us the topic called drug abuse. Mr. Aliu Adam, introduce yourself to the viewers, please.
Good day, viewers. My name is Aliu Adam. I'm a public analyst. I'm a social commentator, and I'm a humanitarian. Thank you very much.
On the program today, Mr. Aliu Adam is to enlighten us on drug abuse, and therefore he will be answering 4 questions. As Big Issue program is concerned, Mr. Aliu Adam, are we good to go?
Yes.
The first question, so I think every one of us should try and know this, was drug abuse itself?
Well, drug abuse is broad. It's broad as in it relates to certain fields. In the field of medicine, there are different definitions for drug abuse. It relates to public health, criminal justice, they are drug abuse. But in our social strata, I would like to talk about drug abuse, which is also known as substance abuse. I don't want us to look it at from the angle of drug abuse alone. Drug abuse or substance abuse is a patterned use of a drug or a particular substance in which the user used it in a particular pattern which is harmful to the user and to the community itself.
Okay, good. Viewers, we just have the definitions of drug abuse, and I believe every one of us have gotten the definitions. So we move on to the next question. The next question says, can drug affect individual, community, and the society?
Yes. The effect of drug abuse is wide and it's very devastating. We can group it, like you said, you can group it as effect of drug abuse in the individual level, effect of drug abuse in the community level, and effect of drug abuse in the society at large. When you look at most common types of drug being used in our community, we have the likes of alcohol, we have the likes of morphines, we have the likes of opioids, we have the likes of methaquinone, different types of drugs. But there are also some other substances which we don't look at it as drug abuse, but they have the same effect as drug abuse. We have the likes of this gum, we have the likes of cow dungs, horse dungs, soakaways. People sniff them so that they get a particular kind of euphoria effect. When you look at the effect of drug abuse to the individual, a particular person who is an addict of drug abuse is not going to be useful for himself physically. His productivity level is going to become low. He himself will not going to be useful, he or herself will not going to be useful to the community. It's going to cause damage to the system, his body system. There are various types of diseases which we get from drug abuse as an individual. The likes of lung cancer, one of the major ways in which HIV is being transmitted nowadays is the use of drugs, especially from injecting drug users. When you find a group of people who are injecting drug users, they transmit diseases among themselves easily. Then when you now go back to the community level, in the community level, you now find out that a person who is a drug addict or is a user of drug is not going to be accepted in community. The person tends to portray violence activity, criminal activity are being portrayed by the person. When you now look at the issue of drug abuse to the community level, in the community level or the society level, you find out that when someone who is a drug addict or someone who abuses drug regularly, that person is not going to be useful to the society. When there are vital decisions to be made in the society, that person is not going to be called upon. That person now becomes a liability. Instead of being an asset to the society, it now becomes a liability to society. Those kind of people foment trouble in the society. Those kind of people bring violence back to the society. Thank you very much.
If you are just joining us, we are with Mr. Aliu Adam. He is discussing with us drug abuse. We move on to the next question. Nowadays, when we look at our community, we get to know people are more addicted to drug abuse. So, Mr. Aliu Adam, why do some people become addicted? Why others don't?
Well, when we talk about addiction, many people don't understand why and how they become addicted to drugs. Some people feel people who become addicted to drugs, they don't have principle. They think it is so easy for you to just start using drugs and leave and remove yourself from the use of drugs simply by choosing not to use it. In reality, drug addiction is a complex disease that is eating into the fabrics of our society. You find out that majority of our youths are now becoming drug addicts. Drug addiction is a major, is a canker worm eating into the fabrics of our society. Nobody chooses to become an addict of drug, but there are so many factors. We have the societal factors, we have the individual factor, we have the emotional factor. We have so many factors playing into being. For someone, people feel when a particular issue occurs to them in the society, such as failure, when they try a certain particular kind of trait and they fail, they feel, the next thing I'm going to resort to is drug, which is very bad. So drug addiction is not something you can pinpoint that, this is a particular thing that makes a particular set of people become addicted to drugs. Drug abuse is hydrated. It contains series of factors that play into, that comes into play to, that can make some, to class a particular person as a drug addict. Thank you.
Oh, good. Mr. Liu Hadam, I've answered three good questions and I've enlightened us on drug abuse. So we have just one question left, sir. How can the government play a role in drug abuse treatment?
Yeah, well, in the issue of Nigeria as we have today, there are a number of agencies working in the as regards drug enforcement and drug abuse in Nigeria. We have the likes of the Nigerian Drug Law Agency. Well, government has not done enough as regards drug abuse in Nigeria. One of the major ways I feel the government should still put in more effort is the area of awareness. When people get more aware that this particular thing is not good for the body, this particular type of substance is not good to be taken, rather than banning them, let people be aware. When, if you notice, some few years back, there was this headline making news all around that codeine. What our government did was they brought out a policy outright banning of codeine circulation in the system. Well, it is a good motive, but you find, I can bet it to me, when you walk to a particular store now, you will still find codeine being sold at exorbitant prices. Drug addicts still find money to buy it. I find one of the major ways I think our government can come in is through job creation. When there are jobs for every strata of everybody leaving school, the issue of drug addiction will be